Today, individual armor protection has become a common part of the equipment of soldiers in modern armies, not to mention special forces operators. Their training takes years and costs hundreds of thousands of dollars. These are very expensive units, and there's never too many of them, so they must be protected at all costs. But if you look at United States Special Forces operators like TACP, DEA, Secret Service, and others, we see that they are wearing light body armor. They don't cover most of their abdomen, sides, and back, whereas United States Army soldiers wear large body armor, and their helmets provide a larger area of protection. What's more, we can see this difference in many other countries as well. But how is that? First, we need to learn more about individual armor protection. What kind of body armor is used by soldiers and special forces? Modern armor protection can be divided into two types: the classic full-size ballistic vest and a compact model, which is called a plate carrier. The American AOTV, Russian 6B45, or German Mobust armor can be referred to the first category. The plate carrier models include the JPC or AVS models. There are also intermediate variants, which are called plate carriers but have a larger area of protection. These include the tacp or LBT6094 models. But it's not that simple. The fact is that many people think that modern armor looks roughly like World War II body armor, where its entire area offered equal protection. Well, it isn't so. The point is that over time, two types of armor have emerged: armor against bullets and against shrapnel. Armor plates are responsible for bullet protection. They can be steel, ceramic, titanium, etc. In Western armies, sepi and esepi plates are widely used, and Russia uses granite plates. They are placed in the dorsal and thoracic parts. Their size and shape are specially designed so that they protect vital organs. The so-called soft armor, made of aramid fibers, is responsible for protection against shrapnel and fragments from explosives. It is inserted into almost all sections of the body armor. It is more flexible and thin. That's the catch. A soldier in a large ballistic vest and a special forces operator in a small plate carrier usually offer the same protection from bullets. The same number of plates fit in their armor. Some might say that the ballistic vest has an extra two slightly smaller plates that are stacked on the sides. But exactly the same plates can be attached even to a small JPC if you add side pouches to it. By the way, sometimes armor vest provides even less protection. For example, the area of bullet protection of the Russian 6B23 ballistic vest is less than that of the small JPC plate carrier. So, the difference is not in quantity or size of plates. What really matters is the quantity of soft armor. Some believe that in a war, most casualties happen due to small arms. In fact, it was estimated after the World War II that the small arms casualty rate was about 22%. The main cause of casualties was shrapnel, and that is artillery and mortar fire. It was the reason of more than 60% of casualties on a battlefield. That's exactly why modern ballistic vest or armor vest is so big. It can fit more soft armor. But why don't the special forces have enough soft armor? It's all about mission differences. Often, special forces are tasked with reconnaissance, aerial targeting, using light artillery, or stealthy elimination of bad guys. This means that special forces operators often simply don't have the need to put on full armor, as the likelihood of encountering shrapnel is minimal. That said, speed, surprise, and mobility take higher priority. Sometimes, special forces have to deal with regular criminals in the city. Therefore, the use of lighter helmets, such as the Obscure Fest, which doesn't protect the ears, in contrast of the Army ACH or MiG-2000 helmets. But this doesn't mean that the special forces only wear lightweight carriers. Sometimes they wear even more armor than soldiers do. That includes neck, shoulders, face protection, shields, and other stuff. A good example are SWAT or FSB operators. The reason is simple. They work in a limited space and may encounter tough bandits or fanatics who can blow the place up any second. So, the operators have to gear up really well. That's all for today. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe to the channel. See you next week.